Hello students, in this video I am going to explain about Morgan's experiments. Morgan gave chromosomal mapping by conducting experiments on Drosophila melanogaster, that is fruit fly. So before, generally students get confused with these diagrams given in NCERT. So this is cross A, first cross, first dihybrid cross conducted by Morgan in Drosophila melanogaster. This is second cross. So this is about the results of cross. So generally students, they don't understand these diagrams given in NCERT. So now I'm going to clear those, I'm going to explain those, and I'm going to give you some tricks related to these experiments, Morgan's experiments. So before studying these Morgan's experiments, let's study some details about Drosophila melanogaster, that is fruit fly. So actually in fruit fly totally there are 8 chromosomes, diploid number of chromosomes. Among 8 chromosomes, 6 chromosomes are somatic chromosomes or autosomes, 2 chromosomes are sex chromosomes or allosomes or heterosomes or idiosomes. Okay, let's see the condition in case of female. Let's see the condition of sex chromosomes in case of female fly. So in female fly, the sex chromosomes or the allosomes are 2. They are XX chromosomes. Both the X chromosomes are similar. Hence, this condition is called as homomorphic condition. They are homologous to each other. Homologous to each other because the type of genes present on them, the gene location, and with respect to centromere, both of these chromosomes, X chromosomes, are similar to one another. So they are homologous to each other. So this condition is called homomorphic condition. Next, coming to male fly. In case of male fly also, there are 2 sex chromosomes, that is X and Y chromosomes. But these X and Y chromosomes are not homologous to each other because, let's say this is X chromosome and this is Y chromosome. Because the type of alleles present on X chromosome are not present on Y chromosome. It's homologous allele, homozygous allele or heterozygous allele is not present on Y chromosome. So this condition is called as heteromorphic condition of sex chromosomes. So this X and Y chromosomes are not homologous to each other. And one more thing is, here the alleles here, let's say this is the X chromosome. This X chromosome is with the genes having alleles like small a, small b, small c, small d are present, but their alleles are not present on Y chromosome. Their alleles are not present on Y chromosome. So here what we can say is single allelic condition is present. So presence of single allelic condition is hemizygous condition. Or what we can say, out of a pair of alleles, only one allele is present in case of male fly. So this condition is called as hemizygous condition. Okay, actually when a recessive trait is expressed, a recessive trait is expressed only under homozygous recessive condition. That means when both the alleles are present together under recessive condition, then only recessive trait will be expressed. But in case of Drosophila, here even under single allelic condition also recessive trait can be expressed. So expression of a trait even under single recessive allelic condition is called as pseudodominance. So what is dominance? Actually, dominance is nothing but expression of a trait under single or both the dominant allelic conditions is called as dominance. Here pseudodominance means expression of a trait even under single recessive allelic condition is called as pseudodominance. Actually, recessive trait is expressed only under homozygous recessive condition of a gene, but dominant trait can be expressed under homozygous dominant condition of a gene or heterozygous dominant condition of a gene. So dominant trait can be expressed even under single allelic condition generally, but recessive trait cannot be expressed under single allelic condition. So the expression of a trait, that is recessive trait even under single allelic condition of a gene is called as pseudodominance. So here male fly can exhibit pseudodominance. So this is all about fruit fly. Now let's study the experiments conducted by Morgan on fruit fly. So actually Morgan chose three characters in fruit fly to conduct crosses in Drosophila melanogaster. So here those three characters are body color, eye color and wing size. Body color, eye color and wing size. So in this character called body color, there are two contrasting traits. They are brown body color and yellow body color. Brown colored body is dominant over yellow body color. In this next character called eye color, there are two contrasting traits. They are red eye and white eye. So here red eye is dominant over white eye. Next, coming to wing size. So next character. In this character also there are two contrasting traits. They are normal wing and miniature wing. Miniature wing is nothing but it is smaller in size, little smaller in size than normal wing, miniature wing. So these are the two traits. Among these two traits, normal wing is dominant over miniature wing. So these are the phenotypes. Phenotypes: brown body color, yellow body color, red eye, white eye, normal wing, miniature wing. All these are phenotypes. Now let's see how we can represent these genotypes, their genotypes. Okay, so this yellow trait is represented by small letter of its first alphabet, yellow, Y. First alphabet is Y and small alphabet. This yellow trait is represented by small alphabet of its first letter, so small y. And its dominant trait is represented by Y plus. Plus is added as its superscript. So this plus represents dominant trait. Next, in the same way, white, small w, red, small w plus, and miniature wing, small m, normal wing, m plus. So these are the three characters chosen by Morgan to conduct experiments in Drosophila melanogaster. So he conducted three types of dihybrid crosses. So first cross, he made first cross between two flies that differ in two characters. They are body color and eye color. Then he conducted second cross between two flies that differ in next two characters, that is eye color and wing size. And he conducted third dihybrid cross between two flies that differ in two characters, that is body color and wing size. Body color and wing size. Okay, now let's see how he conducted these crosses. So these are the diagrams given in NCERT. Now I am going to explain these diagrams clearly. So this is male fly. So this is cross A, that is nothing but first cross. So in this first cross is made between two flies that differ in two characters. So now this is male fly, recessive, yellow-bodied, white-eyed male fly is crossed with brown-bodied, red-eyed female fly. Yellow-bodied, white-eyed female fly is crossed with brown-bodied, red-eyed male fly. Okay, so here male fly is dominant and female fly is recessive. So this is parental generation. So from these flies, now from female fly only one type of gametes will be produced, that is YW. Only one type of gametes. So 100% of the gametes carry one type of chromosome, that is X chromosome. But from male fly two types of gametes are formed. They are 50% of the gametes carry X chromosome and 50% of the gametes carry Y chromosome. So these 50% of the gametes carrying X chromosome consists of alleles Y plus W plus. Okay, now let's unite. So when the female gametes carrying this X chromosome unites with the male gametes carrying X chromosome, female flies will be formed as offsprings. When the female gametes carrying X chromosome unites or fertilizes with the male gamete carrying Y chromosome, then male fly will be formed. So this is female fly of F1 generation, this is male fly of F1 generation. So YW, this is the gamete carrying YW coming from female gamete. This is next Y plus W plus carrying X chromosome coming from male fly. So this is YW, Y plus W. This one in male fly, YW. Y chromosome is now not carrying any alleles. Okay. So this is about F1 generation flies. So in F1 generation, you observe here, in F1 generation, female fly is dominant but male fly is recessive. But in case of parental generation, female fly is recessive and male fly is dominant. Next, coming to F1 generation gametes. So from this F1 generation, four types of gametes are formed. Those four types of gametes are, two types are parental types and two types are recombinant types. Two types are recombinant types. Why these recombinant types are formed? Because these X and X chromosomes are homologous to each other due to crossing over and segregation during the formation of gametes. There are two other types of gametes. There is two other types of gamete formation occurs, that is recombinant type of gametes. So parental type of gametes. So YW, this one. Next Y plus W plus. So these two are parental type. Next, these two are recombinant type. Recombinant type because this W plus will be shifted onto this one. This W will be shifted onto this one. So YW plus. Next one, Y plus W. So two types of recombinants and two types of parental types. So how many types totally? Four types of gametes will be formed by female fly. In case of male fly, only two types of gametes will be formed because these X and Y chromosomes are not homologous to each other and hence there is no crossing over, there is no recombination. So only two types of gametes are formed, that is only parental types only. So YW, this is Y chromosome. Next, so when these female gametes, all four different types of female gametes unite with male gametes carrying X chromosome and the male gamete carrying Y chromosome, now what happens? Female flies and male flies will be formed. They are F2 generation offsprings. So all these are F2 generation offsprings. All these are F2 generation offsprings. Now let's see F2 generation offsprings. So four types of gametes. So all four types of gametes, 1, 2, 3, 4, all four types of female gametes unite with the male gamete carrying X chromosome first. Let's unite all this. Then let's unite all the female gametes carrying X chromosome unite with the male gamete carrying Y chromosome. So eight different types of genotypes will be formed. Here how many types of gametes? Four types of gametes. Here how many types of gametes? Two types of gametes. So four to the eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Not eight flies, eight types of genotypes in F2 generation. Okay, now let's unite. Now let's unite all four different types of female gametes with a male gamete carrying X chromosome. So this is YW. Here male gamete carrying X chromosome is with YW. So YW, YW. Next Y plus W plus YW. So Y plus W plus YW. Next, recombinant types. So these are parental, these are recombinant. Let's come here, recombinant types. Okay, so YW plus, the female gamete carrying YW plus alleles is uniting with the male gamete carrying YW alleles. So YW plus YW. Next, last one, Y plus W. Female gamete carrying Y plus W alleles is uniting with the male gamete carrying YW. So Y plus W, YW. So This is about female offsprings carrying XX chromosomes. Now coming to male offsprings. When the female gamete carrying X chromosome is uniting with the male gamete carrying Y chromosome, male flies will be formed. Let's see. So now let's unite all these four female gametes with the male gamete carrying Y chromosome, which results in the formation of male flies. Okay. Now female gamete with YW unites with Y chromosome. So YW male Y chromosome. Next Y plus W plus of female gamete. Next Y chromosome of male gamete. Next YW plus of female gamete and Y chromosome of male gamete. YW plus Y chromosome. Next, YW plus Y chromosome. Next Y plus W of female gamete and Y chromosome of male gamete. Y plus W of female gamete and Y chromosome of male gamete. So like this type of offsprings are formed. So these are parental types. In this line it is given here, you see carefully, these are parental types and these are recombinant types. Why they are parental types, let's see. So here what type of phenotype will be formed? Y plus W plus, that means brown bodied red eyed YW, yellow bodied white eyed. This is like dominant parent, this is like recessive parent. Now Y plus W plus, brown bodied red eyed dominant, it is like dominant parent. Yellow bodied white eyed, so this is like recessive parent. Now again Y plus W, Y plus means brown bodied, Y means red, white eyed. Y plus means brown body, W means white eyed. So here brown body is coming from dominant parent and white eye is coming from recessive parent. That means this is recombinant. Now let's see next type of fly, next genotype. So this is yellow bodied red eyed. So yellow body is coming from recessive parent and red eye is coming from dominant parent. So now this is brown bodied white eyed. So brown body is coming from dominant parent and white eye is coming from recessive parent. This is yellow bodied red eyed. Yellow body is coming from dominant parent and red eye is coming from recessive parent. So all these are recombinants, all these are parental types. So what is the percentage of parental types? 98.7% are parental types. These are 8 types of genotypes, but parental types are 98.7% of the flies number of flies which are parental type are 98.7%, and the number of flies which are recombinant types are 1.3%. So this is about the first cross conducted by Morgan in Drosophila melanogaster. Okay, so in first cross, how many are parental types? 98.7% are parental type of flies and 1.3% are recombinant type of flies. In second cross, in the same way, this is second cross. Second cross also in the same way, but the characters are eye color and miniature wing. Second cross. So same results will be obtained. Same results are obtained when he made the second cross between the flies that differ in two characters, that is eye color and wing size, second cross. So these are the results of second cross. In second cross he got 37.2% of recombinant types and 62.8% of parental types. In third cross, that is when he made a cross between two flies that differ in body color and wing size, he got 61.5% of parental types and 38.5% of recombinant types. So by observing these results, what he proposed is if the recombinants are more means genes are loosely linked, genes present on the same chromosome. All these three genes corresponding to these characters responsible for the expression of these traits are present on the same chromosome, that is on X chromosome. So if recombinants are more means those genes are loosely linked, because if the genes are loosely linked they can be easily segregated. So if recombinants are more means they can be easily segregated from one another. So here in first cross recombinants are less, 1.3% only. In second cross recombinants are more, 37.2%. In third cross recombinants are more than in case of second cross and first cross, that is 38.5%. So if recombinants are more means genes present on the same chromosome are loosely linked. They are loosely linked means distance between those genes is more. So here recombinants in the third cross, that is in between Y plus and W plus, that is in between body color and wing size, number of recombinants are more. So 38.5%. So based on the experiments, based on the results of Morgan's experiments, Sturtevant, his student Sturtevant, for the first time he gave chromosomal mapping. He located the genes present on the same chromosome. Chromosomal mapping is nothing but finding the sequence of genes present on the same chromosome is called as chromosomal mapping, or locating the position of genes present on the same chromosome is called as chromosomal mapping. So here in between Y plus and W plus, distance is less, hence they are little tightly linked. So they cannot be segregated very easily, and hence the number of recombinants formed are less. Next, the distance between genes of eye color and wing size is little more than the first case, first cross. So here number of recombinants are 37.2%. So in case of third cross, the distance between genes is more than first case, first cross and second cross, and hence the number of recombinants is more. So like this, his student Sturtevant made chromosomal mapping based on the results of Morgan, who conducted experiments on this Drosophila. So to find the recombination frequency, or to find the percentage of recombinants or crossover value, this is the, or the distance between genes. So what can we say now? So recombination frequency or the percentage of recombinants or crossover value is directly proportional to distance between genes. That means if the distance between genes is less, they cannot be segregated easily, so recombination frequency is also less. So number of recombinants formed are also less, so crossover value is also less. If the distance between genes is more, number of recombinants formed will be more, so recombination frequency will also be more, so crossover value is also more. But this recombination frequency or number of recombinants or crossover value is inversely proportional to linkage, because if the distance between genes is more, linkage is less. They are not tightly linked, they are loosely linked. If the distance between genes is less, linkage is more. That means they are tightly linked. So these are all, these are inversely proportional to linkage. So to find the recombination frequency or to find the percentage of recombinants or crossover value or distance between genes, formula in case of problems related to this crossover values, we have to use this formula, that is number of recombinants by total number of offsprings into 100. So this is all about Morgan's experiments, chromosomal mapping or the distance, and the distance between genes discovered by Sturtevant. So to represent the distance between genes in case of eukaryotes, suppose 1.3% of recombinants is nothing but, in first cross 1.3% of recombinants, that is nothing but 1.3 centimorgans. So distance between genes is represented by the units 1.3 centimorgans in case of eukaryotes. But in case of prokaryotes, the units for representing the distance between genes is MAP units. We can call it as 1.3 MAP units. MAP units. In case of second cross, 37.2 centimorgans. In case of eukaryotes, and MAP units in case of prokaryotes. Why he gave this units for measurement of distance between genes? Because he dedicated his work to Morgan. So he gave this units as centimorgans. So hope students you understood this concept very clear. This concept is very clear to you now. And by using this formula and by using these tricks and all, you can, I hope you can solve the questions related to Morgan's experiments and chromosomal mapping. In the next video, I'll be giving some questions related to this distance between genes and how to locate the genes present on a chromosome, and even crossover values and all, some questions related to Morgan's experiments and distance between genes. And I'll also give you tricks to solve those questions. Please watch these videos and grab all the concepts and tricks and solve the questions very faster. Thank you, students.